Are you listening? Damn.
Hey, I'm TJ Hunter. Welcome to week 15 of my NFL weekly picks for the 2016-2017 NFL season. I'm doing my picks early because obviously if I do my picks early, I get more viewers. And thank you very much for last week. Week 14, I had over 1,000 plus viewers. I can't remember the last time I had 1,000 viewers doing this. Last 1,000 views I had was a Bow Wow thing, but that's for another day. Against the spread this week and straight up, we're pretty much going to be even. Could be 8-8, could be 9-7. So I just barely got away with week 14 because week 14 was tough. Week 15 is going to be even tougher, so let's get straight on. Oh, before I do that, my video pick, I went 4-1 with that bonus telling you to take the Eagles plus one. Did not happen. Here's my week 15 against the spread this week. My first game of the week will be the Pittsburgh Steelers traveling to the Cincinnati Bengals in a Sunday matchup for the AFC North. I'm going to tell you to take the Steelers -3. Why? Steelers are the better team. Le'Veon Bell had a record-breaking game yesterday. He ran for over 200 and something yards, and Ben Roethlisberger just the man. No other way of telling you. Antonio Brown, he did something, but really hadn't do anything. It was the Le'Veon Bell show in Buffalo, as Buffalo couldn't do anything. And now Buffalo's in trouble because Tyrod Taylor, there's chances he might not be the quarterback for that team next year. We could see Jay Cutler. We could see Tony Romo. Wait and see. Meanwhile, the Bengals blow out winners on the road against the Cleveland Browns, still winless. I think the Browns are going to go 0-16 to get that first pick and forget what they did with the Eagles. Bengals still with no A.J. Green, still with no Giovanni Bernard, but they still making things happen. And oh, gosh, I just don't know what to think. That's why this is a division game. Take the Steelers -3 over the Bengals in Cincinnati on Sunday. My second game of the week will be a Saturday night special. It is the Miami Dolphins traveling to MetLife Stadium to face the New York Jets. The Jets are 2.5-point underdogs in this game. I'm going to tell you to pick them because the fact being is Bryce Petty led the Jets to a overtime win over the San Francisco 49ers, who I told y'all to pick. In week 14, that did not happen. Petty is the freaking rookie who went down that field with his running back and scored the game-winning touchdown. Can you believe that? Ryan Tannehill, Iwobi Adeye, great, but Tannehill is out with some type of ACL sprain. He's pretty much done for the season. They may have to go with Mike Moore. Who the heck is Mike Moore? I forgot his name, but that's their quarterback for the Dolphins. Could be somebody else. We'll just have to wait and see. With that said, Jets are going to win this game. Jets are going to take the points +2.5 over the Dolphins at MetLife Stadium. My third game of the week will be the Green Bay Packers at home facing a division rival, Chicago Bears, in the NFC North battle, which the Packers are still alive in the wild card. Packers are 5-point favorites in this game. Take it. The Bears, they're making a big name for themselves right now with Matt Barkley, formerly from the Eagles, formerly from the Cardinals. Look what he's doing with the Chicago Bears. He almost led the Bears to an upset win over the Lions of all teams, but the Lions pulled that game out. Oh, my. What a game that was with Matthew Stafford suffering a dislocated finger. And, man, he ran in for that touchdown. And, boy, Lions are sitting pretty at this particular point. Moving on. The Packers, like I said, are still in it. They blew out the Seattle Seahawks. Who would think that they would do that in a frozen tundra of Lambeau Field and do that to the Seahawks? And Richard Sherman said that was a wake-up experience that the Seahawks must dwell as they go home. Oh, well. Plus, that was a revenge game for the Packers, getting trounced by the Seahawks in that NFC division game or NFC championship game just a few years ago. So, revenge game went to the Packers, but now they're going to face the Bears. No revenge here. Packers should win this one -5 at Lambeau Field over the Bears. My last game of the week will be the Jacksonville Jaguars traveling to Houston to face the Texans. The Texans are 5.5-point favorites in this game. Who would have thought the Texans, since the early part of the season, will be tied with the Tennessee Titans at 7-6 in the AFC South at just a game? Then again, who the hell thought the Tennessee Titans would be up top of the AFC South along with the Texans? Just that type of season for football, folks. Who should you thank if you're the Houston Texans fan right now? Well, Brock Osweiler has his team in the driver's seat because they beat the Colts by a close margin in that game yesterday, and I would have thought the Colts would have did better than what they did. Now, Luck and company are still streaking, but they're still in a little trouble. Jacksonville just could not get it done with the Vikings, and I told you to take the Vikings, of course, but Jacksonville can still play spoiler, but I still don't have confidence in Claypool, so forgive me when I say this. This is going to be a Texans game that they're going to stomp the Jaguars. I think Bortles will get picked off at least twice and get sacked three times. Hear me out. Three times sacked, two times intercepted. Texans favorite, -5.5 over the Jaguars in Houston on Sunday. Here are my straight up picks for the rest of this
are
week.
Are you listening? Damn.
All right, that'll do it for this edition of my Week 15 Picks of the 2016-2017 NFL season. I'm TJ Harmon here on YouTube, over at _rail on Twitter. Don't forget to check out my YouTube Prognosticators page on Facebook. They give you insights on these upcoming games and give you some tidbits on some of these games as well and moving on further. So check us out on our YouTube page at YouTube Prognosticators on Facebook. Also, you can check out the rest of my YouTube Prognosticators links, which are also down below. Check it out. Doing the same thing I do each and every week. Some good, some great, some even better. So check the links out at the bottom of this page. Shouts to all my YouTube Prognosticators and the rest of you guys. Not too much time to give you the comment of the week that I had about the Eagles. What do you think they should do the last four games? But pretty much, I'm going to say most of y'all pretty much think that they should just fall out and lose the last four games. And I believe that they're on their way of doing that. They lost. They're out of the playoffs. Also, a couple injuries to note. Darren Sproles, he suffered a concussion. He's on concussion protocol. Likely not going to play against the Ravens on Sunday. Running back Wendell Smallwood, he suffered an MCL sprain. He's likely not going to play. And John Dornbos, the magician of the Eagles. He's been placed on IR due to a wrist injury, so tough luck for the Eagles. Hopefully they can get it together next season. And oh, and nerve for Deshaun Jackson to say, love beating his team. Talking about the Eagles. So now, do I want him to come play with the Eagles next season? It's business, I know, but I don't know. But anyway, with that, thanks so much for watching, you guys. Good luck with your picks, YouTube Prognosticators. We'll see you right back here next week for Week 16 as we come down the stretch to this crazy and wow NFL season. I'm out. Peace.